Good morning, students. In my previous lecture, I have seen you some important topics related to topo sheet. There were 15 topics were there. I hope you all have practiced and it is clear to all of you. Suppose if you got any problem, you make the list of your questions and be ready to ask me in my live class. Okay? Now, today, I will give you some of the definitions which are important in your topo sheet. Okay? So first, let me tell you, one question is very, very important, and that is, what is scale or define scale? Okay? So how you will write this answer? If the definition will be there, define scale. Now first, let me tell you one thing, whatever the definitions I'm explaining you today, don't worry if you are not able to write, then when your school will open, that time I'll give you all that definitions in your class so that you can write it in your copy. Okay? So, first you listen it very carefully and try to understand how you will write these definitions. Okay? First is scale. Define scale. So, answer will be, it is the proportion between the distance on the map and the corresponding distance on the ground. Our surface in the form of a fraction. There are three ways in which scales are indicated on the topographical map. So these types are, these are the by the statement. By the statement, what you will write? Here only you will write the example. 2 cm is equal to 1 km. Okay? Next is the bi-representative fraction, which is also called RF. Yeah, example will be 1 ratio 50,000. And the third one is the bilinear or the graphic scale. Okay, so you have no need to explain these by the statement, by representative or linear scale. Okay, you will only write the name and write their examples there. Okay, with that scale. Now, suppose if the another question is also very important, that is, what is representative fraction or RF? Then you will write, this is the ratio between the distance on the map and the corresponding distance on the actual ground. Example, 1 ratio 50,000. This means that 1 centimeter on the map is equal to 50,000 centimeters on the ground. Okay? I hope it is clear to all of you. Now the next, I will start from causeway. Okay? Causeway, if you see in your topo sheet, many where there is a causeway is written there. So what is the definition of causeway? It's a raised metal road across a minor stream or low-lying mercy area where water is accumulated during rainy season. But other season when rain is not there, that time these areas are used for transporting purposes. Okay, so it is called causeway. Now next is the broken ground. It is generally found along the banks of a stream or river in a dry area. This is caused due to gully erosion in areas where there is a heavy rain following a dry period. Okay. Now, in the during the dry periods, what will happen? Due to heavy rain, more erosion will be there. Okay. Due to more erosion, gullies formed in that area. Okay. But when rain is not there, dried, and it changes into broken ground. Now you can see the symbol of that. Okay. So these are the broken grounds. Now next is the depression. In sandy areas, very often depressions are found when the sand is blown away by the wind. As we all know, in the desert area where strong winds blows, and due to that strong winds, it removes the sand from one place and accumulated on the other side. So what will happen there? One side it forms sand dunes and another side it forms depression. The symbol of this depression is capital D, small e and P. Is it clear, beta? Now next is the brackish water. It is found in dry regions where excessive evaporation takes place due to great heat, leaving a high content of salt in the water. And this water is not possible to drink or to do irrigation with the help of this water. Because of that reason, this water is called the brackish water, which can't be used for irrigation or the other drinking purpose. Is it clear? Now next is the fire line. This is the path cleared around the forest to prevent the spreading of fire. You all know in the forest area, it's a great danger is there of this fire. Because of this reason, they drawn these fire lines so that it can protect the wildlife with the help of these fire line. Okay. Now, next is the meander. Meander means what? It's a sharp bend of a river. Okay. Suppose when the river flows, in the path of the river, if suppose any highland will come because of that reason it has to change its path. So in that area they form this meander. Okay. Now next is the confluence. Confluence means it is the intersection point where the tributary meets the main river. You can see in this figure. Okay, that is called the confluence. And if you will see in your board paper, maximum time, if such kind of topographical map is there, they will ask you the question that take out the 4-figure grid or the 6-figure grid reference from of this area where the confluence is there. Is it okay? Okay, beta. Now the next is the embankment. They are the walls constructed around tanks or canals to prevent flooding. Okay. If these walls will not be there, then what will happen? You all know that water will come out and whatever the adjoining areas are there, it creates a lot of problem for that. You remove the more soil erosion will be there, all that problems will come. Because of that reason, these embankments are drawn. Okay. Now the next is the open scrub. It is the land where nothing grows. It is a sign of desert area. It indicates occupation as sheep rearing. Okay. So up to this today. Now in my next lecture, I'll give you some more definitions related to your topo sheet. Thank you. God bless you, beta.